Good morning, everybody, and welcome to this holy Eucharistic celebration. Today is 28th October. We celebrate the feast of Saints Simon and Jude the Apostles, and Mass is offered for the following intentions: the soul of K.M. John, offered by Anil John and family; soul of Martin D'Souza, offered by Rose and family; soul of Andrew Cardos, offered by Cheryl Furtado; Thanksgiving Masses offered by Ludwin Coutinho, Robert Coutinho, Monica Gonsalves and family; Thanksgiving to St. Jude, offered by Mr. and Mrs. Leo de Costa and family; Thanksgiving to Our Lady of Perpetual Succor, offered by Conception Fernandez; in honor of St. Jude and St. Anthony, offered by Ivan de Silva and family; the deceased members of Penny Dustin family; and for the souls of Muriel and Noel, offered by Penny Dustin; and Thanksgiving to St. Jude, offered by Anthony Gonsalves and family. These are the holy men whom the Lord chose in His own perfect love. To them He gave eternal glory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we celebrate the feast of Saints Simon and Jude, the martyrs, the apostles who gave their life for Christ. So today, as we offer this Mass, my dear brothers and sisters, let us thank these apostles and also the apostles who played an important role in our life, leading us in our faith, leading us to Christ. It may be our parents, maybe a pastor, maybe a friend, or a catechism teacher. So, my dear brothers and sisters, during this Mass, let us thank all the apostles who led us to Christ. For our many faults and failures, let us ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Acknowledging our sinfulness, now let us say together, I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, O Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me
to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Along with the saints and apostles and martyrs, let us glorify the Lord.
Glory to God in the
Let us pray. O God, who by the blessed apostles have brought us to acknowledge your name, graciously grant, through the intercession of Saints Simon and Jude, that the Church may constantly grow by increase of the peoples who believe in you. The Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
You are part of a building that has the apostles for its foundation. First reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians, chapter 2, verses 19 to 22. You are no longer alien or foreign visitor. You are citizens like all the saints and a part of God's household. You are part of a building that has the apostles and prophets for its foundation and Christ Jesus himself for its main cornerstone. As every structure is aligned on him, all grow into the holy temple in the Lord, and you too in him are being built into a house where God lives in the Spirit. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Their words grows forth through all the earth. Please repeat. Their words grows forth through all the earth. The heavens proclaim the glory of God, and the firmament shows forth the work of his hands. Day unto day takes up the story, and night unto night makes known the message. Your response? Their words grows forth through all the earth. No speech, no words, no voice is heard, yet their span goes forth through all the earth, their words to the utmost bound of the world. Your response? Their words grows forth through all the earth. Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. We praise you, O God. We acknowledge you to be the Lord. The glorious company of the apostles praise you, O Lord. Alleluia.
The Lord bless my heart and my lips. I proclaim your gospel worthily. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Chapter 6, verse 12 to 19. Jesus went out into the hills to pray, and he spent the whole night in prayer to God. When day came, he summoned his disciples and picked out 12 of them. He called them apostles. Simon, whom he called Peter, and his brother Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James, son of Alphaeus, Simon, called the Zealot, Judas, son of James, and Judas Iscariot, who became a traitor. He then came down with them and stopped at a piece of level ground where there was a large gathering of his disciples with a great crowd of people from all parts of Judea and from Jerusalem and from the coastal region of Tyre and Sidon, who had come to hear him and to be cured of their diseases. People tormented by unclean spirits were also cured, and everyone in the crowd was trying to touch him, because power came out of him that cured them all. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, talk on globalization, you have heard so many times. Yet, alienation based on caste and color still exists. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, this alienation also existed during the Greco-Roman world, the time when Paul and his companions lived. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, taking the example of the temple of God, the temple of Jerusalem, as a symbol of alienation, where it was known as the temple of God for the Jews. There in that very temple you find a walled-in courtyard for the Jews and the Gentiles. And woe to those Gentiles if they ever crossed the border. My dear brothers and sisters, based on that, today's first reading, St. Paul, once again, to the Ephesians. He tells us that the temple of God is for all, barred from every caste system, culture or color. We are all people of God and we are all called by God, and therefore everyone is invited into the house of God. This is a holy place of God. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, I can give you a beautiful example of a diversity in unity, where a marriage took place in this very church. The groom was a Catholic. The bridegroom was a non-Catholic, a Hindu. And the one who stood as a witness was a Muslim. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, in this very church, that very unity is seen very much. So, my dear brothers and sisters, the credit all goes, as it is said in the very first reading, that this house of God is built by the apostles and prophets for its foundation, and Christ Jesus himself for its main cornerstone. Yes, today we celebrate the feast of Saint Simon and Jude. Simon called the Zealot, and Jude, the cousin of Jesus himself. Yes, his mother, Mary of Clophas, was a sister-in-law of Mary, our mother. And Clophas, the brother of Saint Joseph. And that is why, my dear brothers and sisters, Jude is the cousin of our Lord Jesus Christ. And as tradition says, my dear brothers and sisters, both of these apostles went to Persia to preach Jesus to the world, to the people. And they spoke to them about Jesus, and those people spoke to others and the others. And that's how the word of God spread all throughout the world. The seed that they planted grew and spread throughout the world much after even their martyrdom. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, today as we offer this Mass, let us thank all the apostles through whom the Word of God has reached to us. The faith has been implanted in us, which needs to grow to full stature. So all my dear brothers and sisters, we do today is, let us thank all the apostles and the apostles that have played a role in our life. Maybe our parents who caught our hands and brought us to the church. Maybe our co-worker, our friend who brought us back to faith, who brought us back to church. The pastors, the catechism teachers. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, let us thank all these apostles who have played an important role in bringing us to Christ. Let us thank the Lord for the greatest gift of these apostles. Let us together now profess our faith in the triune God, saying, I believe in God,
the Father Almighty,
creator
of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord,
who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit,
born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Offertory. My dear brothers and sisters, our sacrifice, mine and yours, may be accepted of God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
As we venerate the perpetual glory of the holy apostles Simon and Jude, O Lord, we ask that you receive our prayers and lead us to worthy celebration of the sacred mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks, O Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are holy indeed, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." My Lord and my God. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
My Lord and my God.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Godfrey, our Bishop, Apostolic Administrator of the Diocese, Archbishop Stanislaus, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, and for whom we offer this Mass today, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our most chaste spouse, with the Blessed Apostle and all the saints who are pleased throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Summing up all our praise and petition, now let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Dear Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as your way, the blessed hope, and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit."
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace with you. Peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold Jesus, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we called to this banquet.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
जन्म जन्म नो ना तो प्रभु तारा बाळ में तेज अमारो लावो प्रभु तमारो अमारो जन्म जन्म नो ना तो बनी ने आ दुनिया मा आव्या
यीशु मानव पुत्र बनी ने आ दुनिया मा आव्या
आपनो बोझो चकवाने अनेक दुखो सया
आपनो बोझो चकवाने अनेक दुखो सया
प्रभु आशीर्वाद पेछे प्रभु आशीर्वाद पे छे सौने दोरी ले छे
Whoever loves me will keep my word, says the Lord, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him. Let us pray. Having received the sacrament, O Lord, we humbly implore you in the Holy Spirit that what we do to honor the glorious passion of the apostles Simon and Jude may keep us ever in your love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is endless. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please kneel for the Novena to Our Lady of Perpetual Succor. Send forth thy spirit, and they shall be created, and thou shalt renew the face of the earth. Let us pray. O God, who didst teach the hearts of thy faithful people by sending them the light of the Holy Spirit, grant us by the same Spirit to have a right judgment in all things and evermore to rejoice in his holy comfort. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
An act of contrition. My God, I believe in thee, I hope in thee, I love thee above all things, with all my soul, with all my heart, and with all my strength. I love thee because thou art infinitely good and worthy of being loved, and because I love thee, I repent with all my heart of having offended thee. Have mercy on me, a sinner. Amen. For the intention of the Holy Father, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Invocation to Our Lady, we fly to thy patronage, O Holy Mother of God, despise not our petitions and our necessities, but ever deliver us from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Let us pray. O Almighty and merciful God, who in order to assist the human race has willed the Blessed Virgin Mary to become the mother of thy only begotten Son, grant, we beseech thee, that by her intercession we may avoid the contagion of sin and serve thee with a pure heart, through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Novena prayers. O Mother of Perpetual Succor, behold me, a miserable sinner, at thy feet. I have recourse to thee and put my trust in thee. O Mother of Mercy, have pity upon me. I hear thee called by all, the refuge and the hope of sinners. Be then my refuge and my hope. Succor me for the love of Jesus Christ. Stretch forth thy hand to me, a poor sinner, who recommend and dedicate myself to thee as thy perpetual servant. I bless and thank God for having in his mercy given me this confidence in thee. The pledge is, I believe, of my eternal salvation. Alas, too often in past times I have miserably fallen because I had not recourse to thee. I know that with thy help I shall conquer. I know that thou wilt help me if I recommend myself to thee. But I fear lest in the occasion of falling I should cease to call upon thee, and so should lose my soul. This then is the grace I seek from thee, and I beg of thee, as far as I know how and can, to obtain it for me, namely in the assaults of hell, always to have recourse to thee, and to say to thee, O Mary, help me, Mother Perpetual Succor, suffer me not to lose my God. Amen. Mother Perpetual Succor, pray for thy children. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, at the hour of our death. Amen. Mother Perpetual Succor, pray for thy children. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, at the hour of our death.
Amen. Mother Perpetual Succor, pray for thy children. Hail Mary, full of grace, Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, at the hour of our death. Amen.
All together, Holy Mary, succor the miserable, help the faint-hearted, cheer those that weep, pray for the people, be the advocate of the clergy, intercede for all devout women. Let all feel thy need, who implore thy perpetual succor. Thou hast been made for us, O Lady, a refuge, a help in need and tribulation. Let us pray. O Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us thy Mother Mary, whose wondrous image we venerate, to be our mother, ever ready to succor us, grant, we beseech thee, that we who earnestly implore her maternal aid may deserve to enjoy perpetually the fruit of thy redemption, who lives and reigns world without end. Amen. Let us place before our Mother our prayers and petitions, our intentions, our requests, and asking our Mother to kindly intercede for us to her Son Jesus, and through Jesus to our Father in heaven. The Memorare. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, and sought intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly to thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To thee I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother, Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy mercy hear and answer me. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come unto thee. The Lord be with you,
and with your spirit.
Let us pray. Grant, we beseech thee, O Lord God, that these thy servants may enjoy perpetual health of mind and body, and by the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, be delivered from present sorrow and enjoy eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord Jesus Christ be amongst you to defend you, within you to preserve you, before you to guide you, after you to guard you, above you to bless you, who with the Father and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Through the intercession of our Mother Perpetual Succor, may the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Dearest Mother, fairest, ever perform the call on me. Virgin, purest, brightest, fairest, ever steadily cry to thee. Mary, ever steadily pray. Mary, ever steadily pray. Ever send our care and sorrow. Best every day. Mary help in pain and sorrow, soothe this right on bed of me. Meet the golden light of tomorrow, bring the end and joy again.